Can you imagine having to modify the extension of hundreds and hundreds of files one by one? Don't worry, after this video, you won't dread it anymore.
So I've already created the files extension modifier.py and also five files, which are the files that we're going to modify the extension of. So let's get started. First of all, I'm going to import a module that we're going to need, which is OS. Okay. And then I'm going to write my path. I'm going to copy this. And as you can see, I'm using a raw string as usual, just to make sure that these escape characters are actually treated as literal characters. Okay. Then print space and I'm going to print the path. Okay, then I'm going to print another space and here I'm going to ask the user to write the old extension, which is the extension we want to modify. So I'm going to add a dot, okay, and then input, enter the old extension, example, txt. mp3, etc. And now the new extension, gonna add a dot, enter the new txt mp3. Okay. So here we are adding a dot and everything will make sense later on in the video. I'm going to print another space and then just for fun, we're going to count the number of files that we change the extension of. I'm going to add a files counter, I'm going to set it to 0. So what we need to do now is actually get the list of all the files and all the folders inside the specific path, okay, the specific folder that we entered up here. To do that, there are actually two different ways. There's listdir, which I'm going to call listdir, and scandir, which I'm going to call scandir, okay? So listdir returns only the name of the files and the folders, okay? So then you would have to actually use other methods to check whether it's a file or not, make the absolute path with another method, and then make multiple system calls. Here, we need to know all of these things. We're going to use scandir, which increases performance because it actually returns an iterator of the entry objects, which will give us further information about the file, such as the path, the name, and whether it's a file or not, etc. Usually without having to make any more system calls, which means that it's gonna be so much better for performance. When we're done with the iterator, we should also call the method close to close it and free resources, or we could use the with statement since the iterator supports the context manager. I want to point out that I'm not gonna handle exceptions and stuff like that in this video to keep things simple. Of course, you should implement them if you're planning to use the program for other purposes. Okay, so I'm going to use the with statement with scandir and the path, the folder, and I'm going to call the iterator files and folders. Okay. Then as this is an iterator, I can actually loop through that using the for loop. So for element in files and folders, and then for each element I check if the element is actually a file. So if element is file, so now I'm gonna separate the root from the extension. Okay, so I'm gonna use split text Okay, so basically split text returns a tuple with the root of the path as the first element and the extension as the second element. For example, if we have like C users username desktop myfile.txt, the tuple will have the whole path up to my file. So it would be C user username desktop myfile. And the second element would be .txt, which is the extension. So I'm going to do this. Split text. .path. So element here is actually a directory object and it has attributes and methods. We've already used is file, okay? And here path is another attribute, which is actually the path to that specific file. Okay, so split text. Then I'm gonna assign to this variable the first element of the tuple, which is the root, and then extension, which is the second element, okay? A better way to do that is actually to use multiple assignments. So we can do the same thing as above in just one line. So in this case, root extension, copy this. There you go. So basically this is exactly the same as this. So I'm just gonna comment this out. So these are multiple assignments, which means that this method returns a tuple, okay? And here you've got two elements in a tuple. The first element is assigned to this, and the second element is assigned to this. Okay. And now we're going to check if the extension is equal to the old extension. If so, we're going to create the new path, which is the root plus the new extension. And then I'm going to use this method to actually rename the file. So element.path, which is the absolute path of that file, and then new path, which is the absolute path of that file with the new extension at the end. Then I'm going to increase the counter by one. Okay. So now I'm going to write a little recap. And I'm gonna write number of files process format the files counter. Then I'm gonna print extension from to the format, then old extension and new extension. So you've got a sort of recap. Okay, so now what we need to do is actually check if everything works. So I'm going to save the file. I'm going to go up here, new terminal. Okay, so I'm going to run Python and then files extension modifier. Okay, so here we've got a path, okay, old extension. In this case, here we've got five text files. So I'm going to write txt. I'm going to change it to, let's say, mp3. Doesn't make sense, but just to show you. Then I'm going to hit enter, recap. Number of files processed 5, extension from txt to mp3, and then they actually mp3. Our py file hasn't been modified because actually it's py, okay?